Data is all around us. We used to store data on paper in big filing cabinets, but eventually we stored them online in what we call databases. How do we easily pull the data we want to look at it? That's what SQL is for. It's a language that communicates with databases. Welcome back to Glitch, your easy insights into bots, big data, and artificial intelligence. SQL stands for Structured Query Language. People call it SQL or SQL. In short, SQL is the name for a language that is used to communicate with databases that store your data. If you want to pull, edit, add information to a database, you can use the language of SQL to do that. But how does SQL work? Think of a database like a warehouse, data tables like filing cabinets, and data like files. This warehouse or database stores data. The warehouse database was built using coding languages like C++ or C or Java. Now imagine regular Lego people need to access the files. How do they do that? Option one, you could have a storefront built to the warehouse so that customers can ask for files, add files, delete files. But essentially this means you are building something that takes a lot of time, money. In the real world, this is the equivalent of building a whole app just to access the files in the database. SQL comes in, which is the second option, SQL. This is like you hiring a specialized delivery translator. Her name is Sally SQL. She knows how to talk to the database and she knows how to speak in the language of SQL. So if you learn to speak SQL, then you can ask her to get files for you. Okay, so how do you speak Sally's SQL language? Here are the requests you could make. If you're a Lego mayor, you want to know the name of your citizens, you'll ask Sally SQL, select name from Lego people.
The request to select name, that column, from Lego people, which is the name of the table.
Or if you're a Lego doctor and want to know the name of citizens that are higher than 3 centimeters, you would ask Sally SQL,
select name from Lego height, where centimeter is greater than 3.
She returned to Lego people, Sarah and Craig, because their centimeters is greater than 3, and she pulled from the name column within the table called Lego height.
Or if you're a statistician and you want to know both the height and age combination of citizens, but this data is stored in 2 separate tables, here's what you'd say to Sally SQL.
Not all tables are found together. Sally joined the 2 tables because what both 2 tables had in common, a names column. She was able to join the 2, matching by the names in each table.
But you can also do other things. You can add data. If you want to add Joe, who's age 12. Or you can update data, make Joe 13. You can also delete Joe altogether. From creating tables, to joining tables, to altering tables, Sally SQL can do it all. So here are 3 things you need to remember about SQL. 1, SQL is the one language you probably should learn. If you are in business or marketing or sales or anything that you wouldn't normally think you need to learn to code, SQL is the one language you probably should learn. The reason why is because most companies nowadays have an online presence and are keeping records of data on a database. So the more you know how to communicate to this database and pull data, the better you can be at your job because now you can pull the data, analyze it. 2, SQL languages have variations. Different companies with different SQL databases have different SQL syntaxes. They're small variation, so it's the equivalent of having different Sally SQL bots with different accents. 3, SQL only speaks to a specific kind of database called a relational database, which is essentially a database that has a tabular schema. So it's a lot like a data table with rows and columns. Next time you hear about SQL, just remember Sally SQL. Comment down below if the company you work for uses SQL to pull data from the database. Thanks so much, and I'll see you in the next video.